competitors clash onto the main stage. What better way to do it than at the Orange County Goodwill Charity Invitational here at Esports Arena, put together by my man Lux, 2GG Gaming, and of course, Level Up Series. That is the legendary Alexander Baye.
Let's go, Baye.
Baye. That's a lot of history right there in that man. You look at him, like, you just get taken back in time. You just get hit with the time stone. Like, that man has done a lot in this community.
Oh, yeah. He does so much. And just even for esports in general, shouts to Alex Baye, man. Mm-hmm. And both these players, shouts to both these players, Larry and ESAM, both very entertaining players to watch. Of course, I'm pretty sure you've seen a Larry and ESAM set in Smash 4. They used to duke it out with the Pikachu and the Fox, but Larry hit the upgrade button when it came to Ultimate, and looks like he'll be rocking the Wolf, I'm assuming.
That man, hold on a second. Fast Food Jesus in the Twitter.
Yo.
He said, "I ate for your sins." Yes, you did. You ate what I can't. You eat what I can't. Because I have to stay away from, like, Jack in the Box sometimes. Because I don't know what it is about, like McDonald's. Like, it makes my skin go crazy. So I have to eat it, like,
sparingly.
In moderation. Yes, sparingly. So, yes, you ate for our sins. Thank you, Fast Food Jesus. All right.
Shout out to Fast Food Jesus, man. I mean, really coming in clutch when you can.
That's
you
right. That's right. Pray to him. Okay. Let's go ahead and get it. Game number one started out on Final Destination. How fitting right here. So obviously, ESAM is going to do what he does best here versus these space animals. Try to take them off stage and edge guard them for everything that it's worth. But on the opposite end of that spectrum, too, Wolf is a very, very strong character all the way across the board. And has some tricks up his sleeves when it comes to recovering as well, too. You have to respect side special. You don't want to run into that move off stage because that's going to be your worst nightmare. You're going to get spiked.
Tech chase situation. Wow, Larry with the chase down as well. And another thing, you know, Spacey's might not have the best offstage, but they slap on stage for sure. And right now, Larry is showing it. Okay, ooh, and it's so scary because, you know, quick attack is a great move. But if you have
wait a minute.
The drag down.
He just got cooked, and then he hit the directional air dodge afterwards. I think he might have been trying to, like, go for the tech and try to get himself out of that situation. So really good awareness right there from ESAM to just, again, you know, even though you might not win every exchange on stage, figure out what your opponent's character's weaknesses are and try to exploit those. We've seen him do that to Luis earlier. Obviously, he's trying to follow suit very much here with Larry Lurr. But Larry Lurr obviously cut from a slightly different cloth than Luis. So obviously, it's going to be a no easy feat for ESAM, if I may say so myself. As you see right here, there's the dash attack. Something as simplistic as a dash attack was able to just completely shut down the neutral and push ESAM clear across the stage.
And right now, ESAM knows he has lead. He doesn't have to make any moves here. And he's still being quite aggressive, going in for these quick attacks, even just repositioning here.
Uh-huh. Okay. Oh, wow. You see just the one punch? Like, that was the where's my money? Where my money? Okay, smash VODs, excuse me, -dots-TV. If that's a real VODs channel, please hit them up because they obviously care about the betterment of people. Donating $3. Thank you. Thank you for your service. And because I'm going to recite some more Hamilton when this match is over.
Yo, let's get it.
And of course, Fast Food Jesus with the 25. We're all, look, I'm telling you, you got to pray to Fast Food Jesus, okay? The Bible 2 is coming out.
He did so much for us.
He's
done so much for us. A lot of people very underappreciative of Fast Food Jesus, man. Shout out to Fast Food Jesus with the $25 dono. And just like that, ESAM going to wipe up that second stock from Larry.
That's actually crazy. Like, if there actually was, like, a real Fast Food Jesus, that's how he would give back to the community. Just keep donating money so people who don't have it can get out here and eat at Jack in the Box and get themselves a good meal at McDonald's, Sonic, whatever the case may be. Oh, wow, goes for the dash attack that time. My man ESAM looking hungry right here too, man.
Yeah, this offstage situation is still going. Does my man Larry get a jump yet? Can I get this man a jump?
Can we get a jump, Jesus? Lord, tough. Can Fast Food Jesus bless him with a jump or two? Ali.
Yeah, sometimes, man, you got to pray to jump Jesus because
Jump Jesus.
you already know, man.
There's a bunch of other Jesus. There's jump Jesus. There's a man, I directly air dodge Jesus. There's the man, my tag wasn't on Jesus. There's .9 Jesus.
Oh, point.
There's you got wobbled Jesus.
Oh, yes.
There's a whole bunch.
Man, you already know, man. Sometimes you need that extra jump against ESAM because this guy's offstage game is
ridiculous.
Insanely good.
It's so strong. And it's always been historically strong, but that's the nature of Pikachu, okay? Like, he has to do that off stage or else he's not going to win. You know what I mean? We've seen it most notably in the money match that he had with Sam Sora at Pound, because, you know, he could not edge guard Sam Sora off stage because Peach is such a dominant character. He had to keep the match on stage. And I'm going to just be real. Pikachu don't want none of them type of exchanges from Peach, okay? You get hit with a couple forward airs, and that's it. And with that in mind, wonderful, wonderful gameplay right there from T1 Larry Lurr. Switching over to the bird. The bird is the word here.
Yeah, and already the bird paying off. Didn't necessarily take that first stock from ESAM, but hey, man, you got to take those.
We take those. And there's also we take those Jesus as well, too. Yeah. I prayed to him a couple of times, like, hey, we take – I'm sorry, like, hey, I don't make the rules, all right?
Yeah.
But it all started with fast food Jesus, though. So, obviously, again, one more time, shout out to you in the chat. You have been phenomenal this weekend for us.
Right now, Larry's still holding on to these three stocks, but the Nair.
Can we get Bug Zapper Jesus? What the heck? There's bugs everywhere over here by the light.
Show them the light.
Show them the light so we can get these bugs the heck out of here right now. But my man Larry Lurr has certainly seen a – wait a minute. Okay.
Man, getting mixed out here.
Hey, he's in the blender. That's right.
Oh, the reflector the wrong way, though. Larry is going to try and steal out the stock, get some offstage here. Tries to get this lingering fair, but the down tilt is a kill move as well.
Uh-huh. Very, very strong option as well, too, especially for somebody as light as Pikachu in these later percent. Now he gets the forward tilt, and oh, my goodness, give him a little taste of his own medicine. I heard you like the forward air people offstage.
Yeah,
I can do that, too.
Oh, wait a minute. Tech chase situation. ESAM not picking it up, though. Really great roll from the right and the back air to retaliate the press. And wow.
Fast food Jesus. Yo. Answering our prayers once more. We are not worthy, but every day we try to walk closer in your light.
If
Thank you.
If you are not a believer by now, I honestly don't know what to tell you.
I really don't know what to tell you, to be real. Like, if you don't think that Jesus is real, he's in the they're in the Twitch chat donating to a good cause. Okay.
Let's go fast food Jesus, man.
Fast food
whenever,
Jesus.
Whenever you need someone, he's there.
Yes, I'm breakdancing for fast food. Jesus Christ! Jesus Christ! We're doing it for them. Wonderful stuff right there. And you guys can donate to it. You don't have to just leave it up to fast food Jesus. You can certainly walk in that person's light as well, too, and help out those who are less fortunate in the chat. So if you got a helpful bone in your body, do it for the people who shop at the Goodwill. All right. Okay, there's the back air. Larry Lurr finds himself knock off stage once more. Use the reflector there. That's kind of the key difference there for Falco in comparison to Fox and Wolf, is that he can kind of use it as like a get off me tactic to get back to the ledge of the stage.
Okay, but Larry now sitting on his final stock here. You got to be careful, man, because ESAM knows when to be able to take those stocks at early percents with the edge guarding, man. You got to be so careful versus Pikachu. Now ESAM resetting here, but the reflector, this should be the stock. The down tilt doesn't connect, though,
That's
for Larry.
Right. Slowly but surely, ESAM is starting to kind of piece his way back into this. Wait a minute. If at first you don't succeed, you try again. Wonderful stuff right there to Larry Lurr. That was interesting. You know, he goes for the down air. Like, okay, well, hold on. Let's rewind real quick.
Hit him with the rewind.
Let's hit him with the rewind, okay? I'm going the time stone has been activated, okay? The Eye of Agamotto. The fact that Larry Lurr can combo like the way he does, it almost makes me wonder, like, Was Falco purposely designed like that, like to be the glaring difference between the other two? Because, like, Fox obviously can turn one hit into many hits. The same could be said for Wolf. Wolf obviously a little bit more cut and drive a character.
Right.
But, like, Falco's combo system in this game almost feels intentional. Like, it almost feels like they seen what went down in Melee, and he was like,
wait,
sir,
yeah.
we made Pichu good. We made Ivysaur and all these other characters that missed the game good. What about Falco?
Can I get my man Falco back?
Can we buff the bird?
He was definitely absent in Smash 4. You didn't see too much of him.
He was Hawkeye, literally. Like, where were you when we needed your help? Oh, my God. Wow.
Wow. And Larry coming in with a 0-2 death on the bird.
I said a bird. A bird is the word.
My boy Lombardi.
That's right, Lombardi. You guys already know the name. Get that. He's cooking that bird, though. That's super effective if this was Pokemon.
Oh, yeah, for sure. And just like that, with the directional air. And I feel like Larry has definitely been using that directional air dodge quite a bit. And, you know, the bird definitely has a really good jump and double jump. Definitely helping Larry out against this offstage onslaught that ESAM is doing.
Absolutely. Did you see the footwork right there? The double dash out to come back in and gets the up throw. That was some good stuff right there from Larry Lurr. ESAM a little bit confused here in this matchup. I mean, obviously, you have to approach it one way. Like, the way that you would get Fox and Wolf off stage using, like dash attack and things like that. But then you also have to approach Falco differently off stage just because of his air mobility. But regardless, whatever the case may be, Falco just got blown up right there.
Now, ESAM looking like a space. He got the nair to up smash, though. But the up tilt into the back air, definitely Falco's best kill confirmed for sure. It is so strong. He can even get up throw up air in certain situations as well. Directional air dodge working out so well for Larry. He's not have to go into the Firebird there.
That's right. Okay. Lets him throw out the rapid jab. Smart. He wanted to roll behind. The Pika loops. I like that, man. Part of a nutritional breakfast.
Yo, but does Lombardi got the loops as well? Look at that 61 he damage.
Said, I said loops, brother. Brother, I said loops.
Wow.
I said loops, brother.
And just like that, did my man's Pikachu just get gimped? This character has one of the best recoveries in the entire game. And my boy Lombardi out here. Eat chicken, get thick. Thank you for the $10 donation and telling the world what you got to do sometimes on the weekend.
You got to do it. You got to get thick on them, okay? That's two C's, all right? So you know that person's not playing. Get thick on them. Falco's underscore up tilt donated $2. Look, that $2 went a very long way in that last match, if I may say so myself.
It's crazy because Falco's up tilt was actually in that last game, and you out here donating.
That's right, donating. That's canon right there.
Yo.
That's definitely canon.
You put in that work, and then in between the games, you coming in with the donos. Thank you guys so much. Shout-outs to everyone creating Goodwill, and you guys are definitely doing. Keep the donations coming, man. It's all going to a good cause.
All going to a good cause. We got my man on the mic to the left of me, my main man, Korean. Obviously, production's been very strong this week, and ESA's been very nice to us. The Goodwill Orange County facility has been very, very nice to us as well, too. What more can you really ask when you walk into an event? You got a good cause. You got good players, great commentators, and a very strong production staff and team. Come on now. I underscore touch underscore Rods underscore cereal donated $1. Don't ever touch my cereal, all right?
I thought that one was about to get dicey.
That one was definitely about to. I know, right? I was like, hold on. Right. Right, cereal. No, there's a prize in this box here. No, I'm just kidding. All right, let's go ahead and get it, though. We're jumping back into the game, though. Obviously, Larry Lurr going up a whole game right there on ESAM. A very strong swing from both competitors, but it was Larry Lurr who was able to kind of clutch it out there towards the tail end with a very – just a devastatingly placed dare, if I may say so myself. But this is another game, another chance here to reset this thing. So let's see what ESAM can bring to the table.
Oh, look at all these trades
right now. That up tilt, that $2. It's coming in handy, Korean, them $2.
Yes. Oh, this is going to be a lot of damage here for ESAM, getting the jab up on the up against the edge like that. Oh, up tilt, up air, still not enough. And the one great thing about this matchup is it's so fun to watch. And, ooh, so close. Really good job from ESAM, not getting crossed up on that DI. Oh, but there's the swipe.
That's right. Get down tilt. And we talked about that in the beginning of game number one, how potent that move could be versus ESAM because of how light he is, but also how close Pikachu has to stay in the neutral just to put a damage on Falco. Because even though Falco has that really good jump capability, you know, he still is combo food nonetheless. And if ESAM gets in, he's going to stay in. So what better way to keep him out than with the down tilt? But not strong enough right there, though. The dash attack coming through. Is that just tackle attack? That's kind of just tackle attack.
Yeah,
he
hits him with the headbutt, man.
Yeah, that's headbutt. That's what that is.
Yeah, it's such a strong move, and that's definitely one of the bigger differences for like that.
Okay. Getting fancy, but not fancy enough, though. Gets the down smash. Keeping him on stage. There's the dare. He's going to have to stage tech. And he almost was positioned carefully enough to catch him there with the down special. That was some tricky, tricky gameplay right there from ESAM.
Good job hitting the tech. ESAM getting the tech chase, but not losing his life. Wow, the nair into the up smash. Almost connecting here for ESAM. But now Larry finally has some stage control, but ESAM still trying to close out this stock.
And I like what I seen there just a moment ago from ESAM. He wanted to go for the jab lock, and he actually settled for the dash attack because he knew that Larry Lurr would roll backwards out of that situation. So good awareness there from both those two competitors. Very mindful of where each other are at all points in time in this stage. There is another back air, though. Larry Lurr not looking really good here. All right, where's Falco's up tilt in the chat? We're going to need another $2 to bring this. He's going to need some help here.
If we see an up tilt connect, especially by the edge, that is death for ESAM. But ESAM knows he got to wipe the rage out. Gets the dash attack, and just like that, we're two stocks to one here for ESAM. Oh, hey, there's the up tilt. But not enough rage, and it was center stage.
Bars. Wait,
wait a minute.
Up tilt nair.
Loops?
Wait
a minute. We're going to get the landing, though.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, the loops. He said, I don't care if the cereal comes before the milk or the milk comes before the cereal. These are Pika loops, sir. Everybody's getting a bowl.
Ooh, wait a minute. Oh, Sedgehog.
Sedgehog. Standing right next to us. Standing to the left.
With the $5 donation.
Ladies
Thank
and gentlemen,
you so much.
Get you a Sedgehog. If you don't got a Sedgehog in your life, if you don't got a Sedgehog on the mic at your event, you're tripping, okay? Y'all need to start using some of these SoCal commentators.
Oh, that's
you're about to get zapped.
Oh, wait a minute. Larry living here. With the double jump, going for the Firebird, and no tech on that. And a two-stock to return the favor on the bird here. I wonder. I feel like Larry at this point is just going to stick with the Falco. He could switch back to the Wolf or. Oh, Salt the Wizard Art. Thank you for the $2 donation.
Yes. Every little piece matters. And if you are an art page, too, ladies and gentlemen in the chat, please check out some of these artists, too. A great way to keep this community going, the great way to amplify the community, the tournament experience, is to support the artists. There's always artist alleys. There's always vendor booths. Check them out. Even if you don't buy anything, Detective underscore Horse. All right, so Detective Horse is actually a revenger.
Okay.
There's a meme on the internet. If you guys and gals in the chat, if you aren't doing anything, switch over to Google really quick. If you just type in the Revengers, there is Nighty Knight, who is just the knight that sleeps. There's regular Raccoon. It's just a raccoon. Like, he doesn't do anything. He's just a raccoon on the team.
He's actually just a raccoon.
Yep. There's an incredible fella who isn't really strong. He's just a fella who's incredible. And then there's Detective Horse, and he's just like a horse with like a monocle and a pipe. And there's
Detective Horse.
There's one more person on the team too, but that one's not stream friendly.
Okay.
But she's supposed to be like Gamora though. But look up that team. Those are the Revengers, the real Revengers. I don't know about Korg and Meek. Okay. Those were the real Revengers. And had they fought Thanos, there wouldn't even have needed to be a movie. There wouldn't even needed to be a Thor Ragnarok. The movie would have been over.
Oh yeah, for sure. Oh wait, but ESAM trying to get this stock over with, trying to close it out with the thunder there, but Larry getting back on the stage. The forward air not connecting, but this reflector is doing such a great job against these T-Bills.
Again, another up tilt comes out. Really strong anti-air option as well coming out here from Larry Lurr. ESAM right now staying back in the cut, and I love that. Ooh. Gets another jab lock situation, and then the repositioning, the turnaround forward smash really quick for good measure. I love, love, love ESAM's positioning at all points and times with Pikachu. Every little piece matters for this character.
Oh, yeah, for sure. And you definitely need to hit that tipper part of that forward smash to get the stock in that situation. Really good awareness from ESAM knowing that. Now Larry going for this down tilt, gets the down smash, but dang, he's not going to go nowhere on that one.
Absolutely not. 145% and a climbing here for Larry Lurr, using the lasers, tapping into his inner melee roots, because Larry Lurr does have an actual strong history in melee as well, so a lot of people don't know that.
Definitely played the bird in melee and brawl.
That's right.
Definitely the best Falco in brawl for
free,
sure.
Free.
Oh, the down air. And man, ESAM is still alive, 171% right now.
Right, and I like that drag down forward air right there from ESAM, because he knew that he would be at a safe enough distance away to where he would not be able to be grabbed off of a shield punish. Okay, 175% right here, knocking on Death's door. Even a back throw with that last piece of laser would be enough. Boom. Oh, but the laser doesn't connect. Shout out to Kotar for donating $5. Get Goodwill, ladies and gentlemen. Hashtag that up on Twitter. This is a good cause, okay? You love Smash Ultimate. You love Street Fighter V. Some of the best people in the business are here in the building to put on a phenomenal display of action here for you. If you want to see it happen more, keep donating that bread, all right?
Let's get these donos going. And another jab block here, and that is going to be Larry. So ESAM is still alive, 183% right now.
That's right.
Can this man take a stock?
I don't. It's not looking. It's looking very bleak right here. Not for ESAM, excuse me, but for Larry Lurr, if I may say so myself. Okay, using the reflector to keep him at bay, the forward air. Okay. All right. I was getting a little worried. I was like, yo, a three stock? Like, after Fast Food Jesus and Falco's up tilt blessed you, sir?
Oh, wait a minute. Here comes Falco up tilt, though. Oh, wait. Going right into the Falco up air.
Oh, wait a minute.
Dang, there's my man
enter
up
there. Enter the Falco verse.
Oh, but there's an air. There's no double jump here on Larry. Tries to retaliate with the down air. Tries to get back on stage with the Firebird. Whew. So close.
Up tilt trying to catch the roll.
Yep.
Oh, my God. Look at this patience here from ESAM. Just letting him press button so he can find an opening with short hop nair. Get that out of here. Up tilt. Not the best option there for punishing a quick attack on center stage. But I do appreciate the wait a minute.
Oh,
wait a minute.
No.
Wait a minute. Bird. A bird is the word. Oh, what the?
Salem was right.
Salem was right. Donated $5.
He was. Oh, wait. Was he, though?
Oh, I guess he might have been.
Salem was right. The tipper forward smash was going to connect on the ledge jump. Salem got it, man.
It was. We should have listened to Salem. We should not question him. And Fast Food Jesus. Jesus Christ. With the 50 duck. Jesus Christ. Where's the breakdance? The breakdance Jesus. Jesus Christ.
Yo, man. Fast Food Jesus out here being the MVP.
That's right. Most valuable player. Makes his own rules. Call him the mayor, all right? Those are some bars. Those bars might be a little bit older than the viewers in the chat right there. But regardless, Fast Food Jesus always showing the love. Everybody in the chat showing the love. All the viewers at home, thank you, thank you, thank you. Keep the donations coming.
Oh, yeah.